नेक्स्ट लॉ ऑफ केमिकल कॉम्बिनेशन इज लॉ ऑफ मल्टीपल प्रोपोर्शन. इट वॉज स्टडीड बाय द साइंटिस्ट नेम डाल्टन. अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस लॉ व्हेन टू एलिमेंट्स आर कंबाइनिंग टुगेदर टू फॉर्म मोर देन वन कंपाउंड देन द मासेज ऑफ वन ऑफ द एलिमेंट विच इज कंबाइनिंग विद द फिक्स्ड मास ऑफ अनदर एलिमेंट इज बियरिंग अ सिंपल रेशियो टू ईच अदर. सो देयर आर मेनी एग्जाम्पल बाय विच लॉ ऑफ मल्टीपल प्रोपोर्शन कैन बी एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द केस ऑफ कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन. कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन combined together to form two types of compound. One is carbon monoxide and another is carbon dioxide. So we know that what is the mass of oxygen and carbon. In this carbon monoxide, 12 part by mass of carbon, 12 part by mass of carbon is combining with the 16 part by mass of oxygen. It means mass of carbon is 12 in this case, which is combining with the mass of oxygen, which is 16. Similarly, in the case of CO2, we know that what is the mass of carbon. Carbon is having mass 12, whereas oxygen, in this case, there are two oxygen atoms. So it means oxygen is having mass 32. 16 into 2, 32. 12 part by mass of carbon is combining with the 32 part by mass of oxygen. So in both the cases, if we fix the mass of one element, then we can find out the ratio of masses of another element with respect to each other. So what is happening in this case? We know that in both the cases, carbon is having mass 12. It means the mass of carbon is fixed. So what is the ratio of oxygen masses in both the cases? In the first case, oxygen is having mass 16, whereas in the second case, oxygen is having mass 32. On simplification, ratio is coming 1:2. When both the sides are divided by 16, then the ratio of oxygen is coming 1:2. It means this is the ratio of oxygen. This is the mass of oxygen, which is combining with the fixed mass of carbon 12 in both the compounds. So this is the simple ratio of oxygen. Similarly, in the case of sulfur and oxygen, they will combine to form two types of compound. One is SO2 and another is SO3, sulfur trioxide. In both the cases, the mass of sulfur is 32. 32 part by mass of sulfur is combining with the 32 part by mass of oxygen. We know that oxygen is having, single atom of oxygen is having mass 16. In this, there are two atoms. It means 32 part by mass of oxygen is combining with the 32 part by mass of sulfur in SO2. Similarly, in SO3, 32 part by mass of sulfur is a combining part by mass of oxygen, because in this case oxygen is having three atoms of oxygen are there in sulfur trioxide. So if we fix the mass of sulfur, so in both the cases there is only one sulfur atom. It means the mass of sulfur is fixed in both the cases. Then the ratio of oxygen, which is combining with the fixed mass of sulfur in both the compound, is given as 32:48. So this is the ratio of oxygen. So if we will simplify, it is coming 2:3. This is the simple ratio of oxygen, which is combining with the fixed mass of sulfur, that is 32. Similarly, in the case of nitrogen and oxygen combined to form five types of compound. First is nitrous oxide, N2O, nitric oxide, NO, nitrogen trioxide, N2O3, nitrogen tetraoxide, N2O4, nitrogen pentaoxide, N2O5. So the mass of nitrogen in all five cases, in this case, what is the mass? We know that single atom of nitrogen is having mass 14. So in this case, there are two atoms. So it means in this case, there is 28 by mass of nitrogen is combining with the oxygen. Similarly, in this case, only single atom. इट मीन्स 14 बाय मास इन दिस, 28 मास ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इन दिस ऑल्सो, 28 मास ऑफ नाइट्रोजन, 28 मास ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. सिमिलरली मास ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन ऑल फाइव कंपाउंड्स, इन दिस केस सिंगल ऑक्सीजन इज प्रेजेंट, इट मीन्स 16. इन दिस केस देयर आर थ्री ऑक्सीजन एटम, 48, फोर ऑक्सीजन एटम 64, फाइव ऑक्सीजन एटम 80. So to determine the simple ratio by masses of one of the element, we have to fix the mass of another element in all five compounds. So if we fix the mass of nitrogen, in this case only one nitrogen is present, it means it is the simplest oxide. So in this case the mass of nitrogen is 14. So if we will fix the mass of nitrogen in all compounds, we can determine the simple ratio of masses of oxygen in all five compound which are combining with the fixed mass of nitrogen, that is 14. So what is happening in this case, if we fix the mass of nitrogen to 14, it means the mass of oxygen will be half, so it will be 8. In second case, this is nitric oxide. So in this case, nitrogen is 14. So we don't have to change the mass of oxygen. So what will be the mass of oxygen? 16. 8 is to 16 further. In this case, the mass of nitrogen is 28. So we have to fix it to 14. It means the mass of oxygen will be half. So it will be 24. Next, in this case also, the mass of nitrogen will be 14, it means it will be half, oxygen mass will be half, so it will be 32. Next, in this case, the mass of oxygen will be 40. On simplification, all sides are divided by 8, so the ratio will be 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4 is to 5. So this is the simple ratio, this is the simple ratio of oxygen which is combining with the fixed mass of nitrogen which is 14 in all five compounds of nitrogen oxide. So let's see a problem based on law of multiple proportion. So what is the problem? Carbon is found to form two oxide which contain 42.9% and 27.3% of carbon respectively. Show that figure illustrate the law of multiple proportion. So first of all, before starting the problem, write down all the data which is given in the question. So in this case, there are two oxides. Oxide first, oxide second. So the percentage of oxide, that is a percentage of carbon, is given. So by the help of percentage of carbon, we can determine the percentage of oxygen which is present in the oxide by subtracting with 100. So in this case, the carbon is which is given is 42.9% in the first oxide and 27.3% in the second oxide. So when we subtract both the values with the 100, then we can obtain the percentage of oxygen in both the oxide. So in this case, on subtraction with 100, what will be the value which will be coming? 175. 57.1% of oxygen is present. Similarly in this case, on subtraction with the 100, 10 minus 3, 7, 9 minus 7, 2, 7. 72.7% of oxygen is present in the second oxide. So if we fix the part of one of the element, so if we fix the part of oxygen in both the cases, then we can obtain the ratio of other element, that is carbon, in both the compounds which is combining with the fixed part of oxygen. It means it will be following the law of multiple proportions. So let's see what is happening in this case. So in first oxide, in first oxide, 57.1 part by mass of oxygen is combining with the 42.9 part by mass of carbon. So if we fix the mass of oxygen to 1 part by mass, it means 1 part by mass of oxygen will be combining to 42.9 divided by 57.1 part by mass of carbon. So what is the value after calculation? 0.751. So it means fixed part, that is 1 part by mass of oxygen, is combining with the 0.751 part by mass of carbon. Similarly, in the case of second oxide, so what is the mass of carbon in second oxide? Carbon is having mass 27.3%, by which we can obtain the mass of oxygen. So when we subtract this mass with 100, so what will be the value of oxygen? What will be the percentage of oxygen? 100. So 10 minus 3, 7, 2, 7. 72.7% of oxygen is present in the second case. So in second case, in second oxide, 72.7 part by mass of oxygen is combining with 27.3 part by mass of carbon. So when we fix the mass of oxygen, so 1 part by mass of oxygen combined with, on applying unitary method, 27.3 72.7, on calculation value will be 0.376 part of carbon. It means the simple ratio of carbon in both the oxide when it is combining with the fixed part by mass of oxygen. So what is the ratio, simple ratio which will be coming? So in this case, in the first case, the carbon which is combining with the fixed part of oxygen is 0.751. And in the second case, it is 0.376. So on simplification, this ratio is 2:1. It means the ratio of carbon in both the compounds which is combining with the fixed part by mass of oxygen is 2:1, simple ratio. It means it is following law of multiple proportion.